You're watching TAG TV.
Hello viewers, I'm your host Shreya Savijay with another episode of South Asia Focus. Let's begin today's show with the growing pandemic of coronavirus in the subcontinent. Going past 2000, India, largest and the most populous country, has recorded its biggest weekly surge with total number of COVID patients. While Prime Minister Modi has been continuously asking people to maintain social distancing, the state governments are tirelessly working to distribute food and essential supplies. India's neighbour Pakistan, on the other side, is still grappling with communal issues as companies and NGOs involved in ration distribution are consciously discriminating against the minorities. Have a look.
Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi asked citizens to come to their balconies and gates with lit candles, lamps, torches and mobile phone flashlights in the evening of April 5. He said, "This event will reaffirm that during the isolation period, no one is alone and the light will help in fighting the darkness of the coronavirus pandemic." Modi had earlier announced a countrywide lockdown on March 24, under which no one is allowed to step out of houses till April 15, except for essential needs.
5 April ko रविवार को रात 9 बजे घर की सभी लाइटें बंद करके घर के दरवाजे पर या बालकनी में खड़े रहकर 9 मिनट के लिए मोमबत्ती, दिया, टॉर्च या मोबाइल की फ्लैशलाइट जलाएं। चारों तरफ जब हर व्यक्ति एक एक दिया जलाएगा तब प्रकाश की उस महाशक्ति का एहसास होगा जिसमें एक ही मकसद से हम सब लड़ रहे हैं, ये उजागर होगा। उस प्रकाश में, उस रोशनी में, उस उजाले में हम अपने मन में ये संकल्प करें कि हम अकेले नहीं है। इस आयोजन के समय किसी को भी कहीं पर भी इकट्ठा नहीं होना है। रास्तों में, गलियों में या मोहल्लों में नहीं जाना है।
Meanwhile, senior Islamic religious leaders and scholars appealed to all those Muslims who attended a religious meeting in Delhi and remained untraceable to surrender to local authorities to prevent further spread of coronavirus. Thousands of people from across India and some from countries like Malaysia and Indonesia had visited the headquarters of the Sunni Muslim missionary movement Tablighi Jamaat in a narrow winding Delhi lane in mid-March, participating in prayer sessions and lectures over several days.
जो जमाती फंसे हुए हैं मस्जिदों के अंदर जहां भी तो वो बराए मेहरबानी करके वो लोग सामने आए और सरकार को लोकल एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन को इत्तला दें। ये छुपने की बात नहीं है, ये आप इससे कोई डर खौफ बिल्कुल ना करें। ये क्वारंटाइन अगर करेंगे, क्वारंटाइन का मतलब आपको कोई सजा नहीं दी जाएगी, ये सिर्फ आपकी और दूसरों की हिफाजत के लिए है।
Local administrations across India have traced most of the attendees, however, a significant number of them are still untraceable. Meanwhile, various state governments across the country have been tirelessly working to prevent the spread. They have made special arrangements for the poor and the needy. While an economic stimulus was announced earlier to provide them a reprieve, community kitchens and free food has been arranged for them across the country. A contrary and inhuman picture has emerged from India's neighbor Pakistan, where a systematic exercise has kept the poor away from receiving essentials. Organizations involved in the distribution are not giving Hindus and Christians the food sanctioned for them.
Corona virus ki wajah se hum gharon mein baith gaye hain, hame koi ration washan milta nahi hai aur bahar jaate hain to police dande maarti hai aur ghar mein bhagati hai, to hum ghar mein baith ke bhi kya bhookh mare, hamare chote chote bachche hain to hum kahan se khaye, hame to kuch milta hi nahi hai.
अच्छा, ये जो बाहर जो एनजीओज वाले या दीगर जो राशन दे रहे हैं वो क्या हिंदू बिरादरी को दे रहे हैं?
नहीं, हमें हिंदू बिरादरी को कुछ भी नहीं देते हैं. हम जाते हैं तो कहते हैं आपके लिए नहीं है, वहाँ उनके आते हैं जितने भी, तो उन लोगों को देते हैं, हमें कुछ भी नहीं देते, हमें भगा देते हैं वो लोग.
Activists have called it a systematic design of suppressing the minorities. They say that these instructions are coming straight from Islamabad and Pakistan is exploiting the crisis against the minorities.
Discrimination ye hai ki wo ration jo hai wo hinduon aur christians aur jains aur parsiyon ko nahi diya ja raha. To wo jab poochte hain ki bhai hamara ration hame kyu nahi de rahe, to wo kehte hain ye aapke liye nahi hai, aapke liye alag se truck jo hai आपके नेबरहुड में पहुंचा दिया जाएगा, आपके इलाके में पहुंचा दिया जाएगा. लेकिन ऐसा कोई ट्रक वहां पे आज तक तो पहुंचा नहीं है और उनको बाहर भी नहीं निकलने देते. बाहर निकलते हैं तो पुलिस उन पे तशद्दुद करती है. लिहाजा लोगों के घरों में इस वक्त जो हिंदू फैमिलीज़ हैं और क्रिश्चियन फैमिलीज़ हैं उनके घरों में इस वक्त खाने के लिए कुछ नहीं है.
Pakistan has shut all markets, public places and is discouraging large gatherings amid the coronavirus pandemic, rendering daily wage workers jobless. The government announced it would be disbursing 12,000 rupees to low-income earners as part of a $940 million economic stimulus package. Social distancing has been thrown to the wind in Pakistan as authorities struggle to enforce it, especially among the country's poor, as many head out to purchase food in fear of the coronavirus spreading and a curfew being imposed.
Moving on to Bangladesh, where the lives of people on the lowest rung of economic ladder have become miserable. They do not have anything to eat as employment opportunities are shut due to coronavirus pandemic and their little savings have exhausted. That Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina has extended the lockdown until 11th April. The poor are not only finding it hard to cope with the misery, but the absence of a square meal from their routine has further pushed their lives towards vulnerability. Hungry and desperate rickshaw pullers in capital Dhaka have had their vehicles confiscated by police as they ventured out into the capital hoping to earn some money. City landscape has completely transformed in past few days since the outbreak of the pandemic COVID-19. Long lines of people were also waiting for a food truck which came by to distribute free food and face masks for many of the city's poor, whose numbers are increasing rapidly as they cannot find work. However, this doesn't appear enough as the quality of life is deteriorating sharply in the country, which is already a poor country.
চার চারটা বাচ্চা স্যার सेक्टर में सर ना खाया ना राज करी इसको ले भाई रेस्टम करो ना आठ का रक्षण सर भाषा जाएगा ना खाया भाषा मुरा था इगा सर की करूँ
Most of the works have been shut. The government has even asked to suspend the services of banks and few other government offices. Long queues are seen forming at the ATM, which are still operating after banks were closed.
Most of the bank Dhaka shohore bondho, gota koyekta ATM booth khola. এই জন্য এখানে টাকা জমা দিতে আসছি
বাংলাদেশ which has seen 51 cases and 5 deaths from COVID-19 announced a nationwide shutdown until early April however it was extended in the line of growing number of patients and fatalities across the world Country's nationwide lockdown has left much of the impoverished population of the city's capital Dhaka without work or proper meals. Hundreds gathered outside of a food distribution truck to collect rations sponsored by several wealthy individuals.
গরিবরে কেউ দেয় না গরিবকে কষ্ট করে খায় এই চাল ডাল দেয় এই যে চলে
দ্য শাট ডাউন উইচ দি গভর্নমেন্ট কন্টিনিউস টু রেফার টু অ্যাজ এ জেনারেল হলিডে উইল অফিশিয়ালি এন্ড অন ফ্রাইডে এপ্রিল 9th বাট দ্য নেক্সট টু ডেজ আর দি রেগুলার উইকেন্ড দ্য পুয়ার সে দে উইল হ্যাভ টু সাফার থ্রু দিজ 9 ডেজ as no employment opportunity will be available in these 9 days.
আমাদের রাস্তাঘাটে কোনো কামকাজ নাই আয় উন্নত নাই এটা লাগে মসজিদে আমরা খাইতে আসি
The administration found it hard in the beginning to contain the spread as people brazenly flouted the orders issued by authorities. They gathered in huge numbers on the days of prayers, which could prove to be the potential epicenter of the outbreak in the country. The government has tried enforcing social distancing measures, but even they have had a limited success as of now. Moving on, war torn Afghanistan has released a number of prisoners to reduce the speed of the spread of COVID-19. While some have been awarded clemency owing to their old age, others have been pardoned for their trivial crimes. The administration, however, has made it clear that members of the Taliban and the Islamic State will not be released in this process. A separate exercise under the peace agreement has been going on for that but is yet to give results.
Afghanistan started releasing prisoners in an attempt to prevent the spread of the coronavirus. The process began after Afghan Presidential Palace issued a decree last week to release around 10,000 prisoners over the age of 55 in an attempt to curb the spread. Those released, however, will not include members of Islamist militant groups, the Taliban or Islamic State, and the process will be completed within 10 days.
خدا کنه که این پروسه همچنان ادامه پیدا کنه البته نه پروسه کرونا پروسه رهایی
The Afghan Health Ministry estimates up to 40% of Afghanistan's 32 million people could be infected. Government efforts to persuade people to maintain social distancing have proven futile amid the rush of returnees and a general lack of adherence to safety guidelines. Due to high rates of illiteracy and a fatalistic attitude towards life.
فرمان اختصاصی در مورد ویروس کرونا که به ما رسیدک ما شروع به اقدام کردیم. در شب اول 141 نفر رها کردیم. در حدود 400 الا 500 نفر ما از مطابق همین فرمان رها میکنیم.
Afghanistan has reported scores of new cases of coronavirus and the number of new deaths is most likely to go up in coming days. There are fears Afghanistan's vulnerable health system, devastated by years of war, would be overwhelmed by an outbreak.
ما احساس خیلی خوشی داریم و خیلی هم احساس خوبی میکنیم از اینکه این اقدام دولت به خاطر از این جلوگیری از این مرضی اقدام کرد.
Meanwhile, in a video shared by Taliban spokesperson Zabihullah, members in full personal protective equipment can be seen providing sanitizers and brochures to attendees in an effort to spread the awareness for the virus. Afghan authorities have quarantined 16 health workers, including 6 doctors, as Afghans fleeing hard-hit Iran have helped spread the coronavirus in the western border province of Herat. Afghanistan, already battling a shortage of food and medicine amid a Taliban insurgency, has recorded most number of cases from Herat, a bustling province that shares a porous border with Iran, the worst affected country in the Middle East.
As coronavirus pandemic is taking heavy toll on people's lives across the world, South Asia is widely emerging as one of the most affected regions with complete lockdown, receding economy and blocked tourism with stranded tourists. Nepal, one of the favorite tourist spots in South Asia, is under complete lockdown, but tourists from across the globe, however, are trying their best to get repatriated to their natives. A report.
The pandemic of COVID-19 is bringing chills to government and citizens of all the nations from most big and small continents. While developed countries seem to have already surrendered to the disease with highest number of reported cases and deaths, developing nations are trying to learn from their mistakes and thus implementing all possible strategies to control the spread of this deadly virus. The Himalayan nation Nepal in South Asia seems to have learned very fast as its government imposed a nationwide lockdown only after the second reported case of COVID-19. With the numbers increasing to 5, the lockdown is being followed very stringently, with Nepalese police detaining people in Kathmandu who are believed to be defying the government lockdown. While the locals are being strictly advised to follow the government's guidelines, there are stranded tourists in the country who are waiting to go back to their home. This week, the United States of America evacuated 302 American nationals along with 9 Nepalese children from the corona-hit country.
I'm 65, I'm at risk for getting this virus, and the medical care would be better at home if I do get sick. Also, I have a husband at home. He wants me home, so I need to get home so that I don't end up, you know, possibly being here for a long time if they stop flights coming. So,
U.S. Ambassador to Nepal, Randy Berry, informed that the U.S. government was arranging the evacuation for those American citizens who want to go home at this moment of crisis.
You know, I think that anytime you see a crisis like this, people want to be with their families. So I think people, you know, are making their decisions based on a variety of options. What we're doing here is just making sure that American citizens who want to go home have the ability to do so.
Tourists had become stranded in Nepal after the government extended its lockdown until April 7th midnight as a part of efforts to contain the spread of COVID-19 in the country. Over the weekend, 3 chartered planes had evacuated more than 900 stranded European tourists, mostly German and French citizens, from the Himalayan nation.
Moving on, in the section of culture, we'll show you how the festival of Chaitra Navratri is celebrated across the country. Celebrated in the month of Chaitra, which typically falls in the Gregorian months of March and April, Chaitra Navratri is one of the most revered festivals in Hinduism. Dedicated to 9 forms of goddess Shakti, the festival celebrates the victory of good over evil. The temples light barren as people prefer to perform all the rituals at their residence itself.
Temples in India were lying barren during the 9-day-long Hindu fasting festival of Chaitra Navratri, which is dedicated to the Hindu goddess of power Durga, as the country observed 3-week lockdown to combat coronavirus. Temples across various cities, which are usually bustling and are packed with a sea of devotees every year during Navratri, were left abandoned this time as people supported the Prime Minister's move to curb the spread of the contagion. The 9-day fasting festival of Navratri is celebrated with much fervor across India. However, coronavirus fear dampened the spirit of the Hindu festival this time. In capital New Delhi, only those people that too very few in number paid their obeisance at the temples who live very close to them.
चैत्र नवरात्र आज से प्रारंभ हो चुके हैं ये जो भक्त खड़े हैं इन सब आसपास से आए हैं जैसा मोदी जी ने ऐलान किया कंप्लीट लॉकडाउन भक्तों का कोई यहां पे जमावड़ा नहीं जो 4-5 भक्त आप देख रहे हैं ये सब आसपास के यही प्रार्थना करने कि हे माता रानी इस जो महामारी है इससे देश को मुक्ति मिले
इन मुंबई सिटीज फेमस मुंबा देवी टेम्पल प्रीस्ट ऑन द फर्स्ट डे ऑफ नवरात्रि परफॉर्म रिचुअल्स विद इन क्लोज डोर्स to mark the beginning of the festival and prayed for the eradication of the coronavirus epidemic.
Maa Mumba Devi se naimittik roop se prarthna kar rahe hain Bhagwati is jagat mein mahamari se bachav karna aur jo ye mahamari phaili hai uska jaldi se jaldi si navratri mein nivaran ho.
Even on the last day of Navratri, which is observed as Ram Navami, the birth anniversary of Lord Ram, temples laid silent and deserted. Devotees offered prayers either at their homes or outside closed temple doors. Even in Ayodhya city, which is regarded as the birthplace of Lord Ram, shops remained closed and police guarded the temples to avoid any gathering.
Ayodhya shant hai. Isliye shant hai ki yah itna bada mahamari hai, chhuachhut ki bimari hai, agar hum isi desh mein rehte hain, isi sarkar mein rehte hain, तो सरकार के आदेश को पालन करना चाहिए हर नागरिक को।
Navratri is celebrated in the honor of 9 manifestations of Hindu warrior goddess Durga. Durga is depicted as riding a raging lion, holding weapons in her 10 hands. It is believed that during Navratri, goddess Durga descends on earth, ridding it of demons, and blesses her devotees with happiness and prosperity. It is also believed that Lord Ram was born to eradicate evil from the earth. His saga is depicted in the Ramayana scripture.
Such festivals are otherwise the essence of the daily lives of India. With that, we come to the end of this week's episode. See you next week. Goodbye and take care.